Okay, we got X, Schizophrenia. This album is it actually called Question Mark? I didn't know it was called Question Mark. Anyways, this album, I know there's a lot of dope songs on it, so I got, I don't want to say I got high expectations, but I am expecting some good shit. Yeah, check it out, man. It's like a muted pluck. What's up with that? Voices in your head. Sausage and ginger for men to make it all, make your own. Wow, they actually, dude, that scream would have, if this was like produced with his older work, I feel like that scream would have been actually ear piercing, because I know how like that the loudness were really loud in his older tracks, but with this one, since it's his debut album, I believe they made sure the production was evened out and just well mixed. This, bro, I called it, dude. This shit's sick, dude. I'm getting Speeding Bullet to Heaven vibes. And we already know X fuck with Kid Cudi, especially Speeding Bullet to Heaven, because he did his own cover slash remix of the one song on Speeding Bullet to Heaven, Postmortem Boredom. I don't think he did the beginning part, because it was a two-part track, and he only did the ending part, I'm pretty sure. I can't remember. I'm pretty sure he did. Edge of the Earth, Postmortem Boredom. Dude, but the vibe, bro. I'm definitely getting the Speeding Bullet to Heaven vibes on this. And it's not your rap shit. It's not your typical rap shit, dude. This is sick, dude. This is the fucking, bruh. That's what I'm saying, man. Whoa, yo, that's wild, because it's schizophrenia. Oh my goodness, the way the track's called Schizophrenia, when you hear voices and stuff and your perception of reality and stuff. He says there's another mind deep in me. This is where I was like kind of like thinking, what does that mean, there's another mind deep in me? Because you got your own mind, and I feel like, you know, he's dealing with these thoughts, and he wants to give up, and he hates himself and stuff, you know. And that's why he says there's another mind deep in me, because even deeper in himself he's screaming don't give up, even though the more outer layer does say I can't keep doing this. But like deep down there's another mind in him, you know. Dude, that's wild. This is a, like, not only is the track sound good, but conceptually it's really like well made and thought out. Like, it's really well thought out, really well thought out. Wow, dude, that track was really short, but really sick. I kind of wish there was more, but like, if another verse came after this chorus, I feel like it wouldn't be, the chorus wouldn't as impactful, you know what I mean? Like, sometimes a short track is nice. Like, it's like when you watch an anime and it's only like 12 episodes, it's easier to give that anime a 10 than an anime that's like over like 200 episodes long. Even if it's really great, if it's 200 episodes long, it's going to be harder to give it a 10, because there's definitely going to be episodes in there that are weak. So when it's like a 12 episode anime, it's easier to give a 10. That's why I say when a track is shorter, I think it definitely is easier to give it a higher rating compared to a track that's like 5 minutes, you know what I mean, like 4 minutes long. This was a sick track. I love how he messes with his sound. He's not just strictly with the rap. We've already heard his other songs that have, you know, like a vibe like this as well, or a vibe where it's more country style. And he can do it. He does, and he can do it, but he can't just do it. He does it great. He does it so well. And man, this was a good one. This was a good one for sure. Even as short as it is, it's a good one. I'll give this shit a pass. I'll give it a 9.5. Like I said, it's easier to give it a higher rating, but 9.5, man. Dope track.